Would you have been a better student if your high school was in a zoo?
I love being in the zoo and being able to have that relationship with the zoo.
Hi, do you guys know how to touch the stingrays?
Because if I didn't, then I wouldn't like know what I want to do with my life. I'd be very confused.
This week, Tag is in Tacoma, Washington because of an email from Ben Warner. He told me that I had to go visit the Science and Math Institute at the Port Defiance Zoo.
When I first started school here, it definitely was a little scary because it's in the middle of the forest. You're learning about animals in a place where there's so many animals. In this zoo, it takes so many animals that can't go back to the wild because they're hurt. They have this community where you take care of each other and help out those endangered species that are out there. You just get a lot of different opportunities here that you don't get at other high schools.
We're gonna start right on time because the sloth is here. She can't walk on the ground, so she spends her whole life like this upside down. She would be very uncomfortable coming down to the ground because she doesn't have the right muscles in her legs to allow her to stand up and walk around.
Drawing endangered species in art class isn't the only thing keeping students like Haley excited for school each day. Every junior and senior signs up for an internship that gives students professional experience in a field of their choice.
On Tuesdays and Thursdays, which is the day I have internship, I'm really excited to come to school, get over with that half the day, and then come to internship and be able to talk to the public and be with my supervisor and just learning as well as like teaching the public.
So you're gonna take two fingers and you're gonna touch them on the side of their wing, so right there. Isn't it slimy?
Now that I'm working with the zoo, I have decided that I want to be a marine biology teacher and not just do marine biology because I love teaching the public about like all of the invertebrates we have here.
Oh, there's one right there if you guys want to touch that ray.
For me, it was a life-changing thing when I started it. I felt like I was getting through to little kids and I was getting through to adults about how much our conservation messages mean to people.
This experiential learning approach in both STEM and artistic opportunities is showing tangible results when it comes to graduation rates.
The graduation rates here are comparatively much higher than the state average. SAMI's graduation rate has been in between 95 and 100% since the school started.
As a public school in Tacoma, the Science and Math Institute's graduation rates are more than 10 percentage points higher than both the district and the national average.
I am preparing to graduate, and I hope in 5 years that I have gotten out of college and I've gotten a job either with a zoo or with a school where I am teaching biology or marine biology or something.
How big are they?
I hope the little kids walk away with just the love of the zoo and wanting to come back and wanting to have that connection with all of the interpreters and the animals. I hope the adults walk away with, this is how I can help.
If you know another educator or student in your neighborhood who's reimagining what education looks like, tag them in the comments now and we'll go tell their story next. And if you missed last week's episode, click here to meet Muhammad, an aspiring firefighter and boxer from Iraq.